I am telling you, this is just the beginning, so buckle up. Monday, there should be more fun, more panic. So cue the fire and expect more chaos. I mean, when you have the biggest bankster in the whole world dumping his shares for the first time ever, Jamie Dimon, something's a-coming. Not just that, I don't know if you got the memo, but all banks are insolvent. This is fine. Everything's fine. I mean, wait until the bank term funding program, the emergency, so many emergencies, they get cut off in March. So maybe he knows something that everyone should know. If you didn't know this, the banks are currently getting loans because they can't survive. Oh, and just in case you wanted to see, it looks like that. That's one of them. Here's your repo. You know, not too many people are talking about that one. Still going on. Also, Tucker Carlson coming out and telling everyone, but everything's fine, guys. Don't worry about it. Go all in on the stock market, which we'll cover in a moment, that there's some abrupt changes. And don't think that this has not been orchestrated pre-market. I mean, all of these things have been in the works for so long. They just keep going. They have time. Now everyone's just flooding over the borders, and then they'll be like, yeah, why can't illegals vote? They should, yes. And then put another point up on the board for Team D. But anywho, what Tucker was saying, this is chilling, which I'll show you. Also, thank you to my subscribers for sending me all of these TikTok videos of like millennials, which I had in my classroom. I'm like, hey guys, you're not gonna survive. I know, your parents say, work real hard, get a job. It's not gonna work. You're gonna get a degree, you're gonna work real hard, you're gonna get a degree in college, and then you're gonna move back home with your parents. And they were like, Mr. Bravo, you don't know what you're talking about. I'm like, yeah, I do. Oh, also enjoy the draft. That'll be good too. Oh, we won't do that, never. Boy, oh boy, do we not have angry and entitled. You put those together and it's called your kids. And your kids that listened to me when I taught them in high school and college, and I said, you have to start a business every year, sorry, are now coming out on TikTok. Little angry.
$5 lattes.
She's complaining about, well, if you guys would just stop buying $5 lattes and avocado toast.
We would still be broke because the American dollar has inflated 62% in the last 20 years. And if we want to retire by the age of 65, we have to save $3 million, which means...
Oh, no, you'll need to save more than $3 million. Even Kevin O'Leary says you got to have $10 million just to skirt by. And my buddy Graham hung out with him at a birthday party, I guess he did a video on it. Looking at this video, I think they probably went over, oh, what expenses is it going to look like? I'll tell you, expenses or income won't matter because everything just changes. Even like you buy a brand new box of cereal. Here, let me open up the cereal. What do we got in? Oh, we got three. Last box of cereal, there was four in there. So it looks like it's shrinking. These puffins are Trader Joe's really good. But where should we start with all of these stories? And I just want to show you this. I got a PDF that... BTFP, all these acronyms. There's no new advances, see? No new advances. Well, unless it gets extended. These are the banks, right? Oh, there's that one. See, this is what your banks are doing right now. They're posting any collateral. Just put it up there. You got your loan. You want a million, billion, trillion. Now you guys know the importance of collateral. That's why you have the bond market. But this is what happens in the banking industry. This is actually a contract. Let's just say it's a bond. And they post it. And then they say, okay, you can have a loan. Perfect. So also, expected cost to taxpayers, right? There's never anything. So I guess the good news is this is going away. The bad news is all the banks are going to fail. But how do you know this, Bravo? Well, even the Fed admits. Like banks, this is not like last March. This is now. Fed admits banks suffered massive deposit outflows last week. It just keeps a happening. So now the banks have no liquidity, no capital, no bond. Well, that's all up. It's all really, really bad. And at the same time, the Fed hasn't done anything. They haven't raised since July. Why is rates keep going up? Well, that's because they're not in control of them. Well, except for the overnight lending rate, and they try to copy the two-year yield. But with all of this banking crisis and more to come, it's gonna keep going. Bank stocks crater below March crisis bottom, hit three-year low. Huh, I thought, so timing the market. Here's what comes next. Well, I don't even have to read the article. Lower. Well, you'll have a bounce. That's just kind of what stocks do. They go up and down. And when I say it's all coming because, see this? all this, these are delinquency rates. Everything. It swings. And it does take a lot longer than I would like. I mean, I'd like just, can we just burn it all down now? It's just, I don't think you're going to like what you see on the other side. But you're like, but bravo, my gold and silver is going to go through the roof. Okay, that's a plus. And I say, why don't you just take advantage? Take advantage of market go down by clicking one button. Also coming in from, I got triggered in the comment section, but it's okay. I want to talk about it. So you guys are like, stop, don't let them bother you. You tell people, it's this one right here, this, and sorry, Patrick, I love you, brother, unless you're another Pat, that would be, I love you, sister. You tell people to sell before earnings. Yes, because it's a coin flip. You don't know. How'd Ford do? Which I'll show you in a second. And I wanted to put that one in my course, which I did. That's the Amazon. I was like, I always exit. And I did it as a joke to show people how you can lose 100% of your money if you do not know what you're doing. And if you'd like to learn how to do it, link in the description, $199. Cheapest ever while I'm filming my options course. And I'd really like to go out on a limb and say, if you're a beginner and you've never traded, I really want you to try it. I've been saying, start with my swing trading course and then you could go into it. But I'm thinking you might be smart enough. I don't know. Link in the description. Also, if the coupon's gone, come back tomorrow because I only have limited coupons for that price. If people did that, this is sell before earnings, because that's what I always say. If people did that for Amazon, they lost. No. You get to keep whatever you just made. Which on Amazon, you could go, okay, I buy it, right? It goes up, you know, this, and then you close, and you're like, oh, it's a swing down. I'll short it. That's it. You just close. Make money going up, make money going down. But continuing, not great advice without research, because research would have done so well. Without looking and just selling is bad advice for the most part. See, what you need to do is come over to Jim Cramer, like with Ford stock, right? What was he saying? Probably go all in, strong. Here's what we think about Ford stock after tentative UAW deal and ahead of earnings. I've made some cash on this one. I think this one was in the course, one of my courses. Look at this, 200. See the 200? One, two, look at all these rejections. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Like, what do you think's gonna happen? It's gonna fail. But I'm still gonna exit. I mean, that would have been a great short, you know, just to keep that one open. But 17% on the way down. I don't know, coin flip. That yellow line under, I trade bear market. That's why I have a bear market course. Also on sale for $199 while I'm filming my options course because people can't get in. Take advantage of that one. If you, here's the DIA. If you want to trade major indices, SPY under it. Well, that's not SPY. This is SPY under it. The only thing that we have left to wait for is the Q. That is also the NASDAQ, and your nine count came on. I said it's gonna bounce here. It's actually a good swing up. No, and it looks like we have breaking news. Hey, this is all inflationary. Sorry, you guys. Prices go, your incomes go up, the Fed freaks out, keep rates here, destroy everything. Because they need you guys to get fired, and you're not getting fired. Or maybe you are, and then you're going to get an Uber job. Worst October for stocks in 5 years. Has investors exiting the market? And I say, don't exit. Why would you exit? Oh, that's right. Because what's that key word here? An investor. Which if you're an investor, just be like Jamie Dimon, right? Where you exit it, which he this is next year. You got it as a CEO. You're like, oh, by the way, I'm gonna exit my shares. Yeah, you should have, you know, given yourself a little bit more time. But you can take advantage of it right here, right there. You short under the yellow, like forever, right? When it goes down, and then when it comes above, you buy. So, and you just take these huge swings, maybe make two trades a year. Actually on JP Morgan right here, that you got above it. That was October 2022. That's a full year. You could turn on my indicators. You buy here, okay? When do you sell? See my Bravo band, the purple up there, which you could change the settings and the color and all that and make it dark or light. I just don't like, oh, sell here. That's it. Ta-da. I mean, your account goes up 22%. And then let's go to the other side. But now let's head over to what is Tucker saying in his latest, oh my gosh, abrupt change is coming. He begins laying out the significant disconnect between Washington and you. Oh, this Is this new? We already have that one. Check. Widespread public. Now that's a big word. Disenchantment. I didn't even say it right. Disenchantment. There we go. We got the petroleum reserves empty, gone. Which that could hit us with an economic shock. And if something really dramatic in your country happens, which it will, I'm waiting. I mean, the politicians are hitting hornet's nests everywhere. Something's going to happen in the United States, and then everyone's going to go, yeah, burn it down. Young people can't get married because you can't afford it. You know, buy houses, have any hope of the future, nothing. And one thing Americans are not used to is being poor. Oh, you will. But there is a solution. Again, start businesses, trade equities. Be like Michael. Be like Mike, right? A Big Short Michael Burry. Ooh. Sorry, Bravo. Bets against S&P 500 and NASDAQ, and it pays off. Digits go up. Hit subscribe to my channel. Digits go up because I can forecast. I can kind of tell you. All right, you crossed under the line. Here's your probabilities. Make digits go up. S&P 500, we're all in control. It's not good. I use the word correction. We're in correction territory. Okay, be making money. And then when it hits the 20%, they're going to go, oh, well, this is definitely a bear market. Now you're kind of too late. Take advantage of how to do that. Because right when you start hearing that, it's like, here we go. And it just wrecks everyone. The S&P 500 could fall another 5%. Test a critical support level that has previously marked the bottom, Bank of America says. Yep. But what is that previous support? Guys, you just draw a line. And here, I'll draw it for you. See this support resistance right there. Oh, by the way, you're under it. And you have an 8 count that came on, then a 9, and then we have a bounce. And then everyone's like, you see, Bravo, you're totally wrong. And then it's going to hit the 200, get rejected. I've done this for so long. And I'm going to keep doing it for even longer. So make sure you subscribe. Hit a like, do something, and I'll see you tomorrow.